Springer had the winning two-run homer in game number two against the Dodgers, which some think was arguably the most exciting and unusual game in World Series history. Morton hurled five shutout innings, allowing only two hits, and was the starting and winning pitcher when Houston beat the Yankees in game number five of the American League Championship Series. A few weeks ago, during the semifinal playoffs between the Astros and the Red Sox, we wrote the Connecticut story of George Springer. We could have included Charlie Morton as well, but, frankly, he slipped under the radar. In fact, until World Series TV announcer Joe Buck mentioned that Morton grew up in Connecticut, where his favorite team was the Yankees, relatively few baseball fans in our neck of the woods had ever even heard about him. After all, aside from those from his hometowns of Trumbull and Redding, Morton was, at best, just an up-and-down major leaguer who toiled for four teams, Pittsburgh, Houston, Philadelphia and now Houston, all in the National League. He recently came into the national sports spotlight in the game against the Yankees that turned out to be Joe Girardi's finale as the New York manager. Charlie Morton adopted by Connecticut. Although Morton was born in Flemington, New Jersey, his family moved to Connecticut at an early age, and he was raised first in Trumbull then in Reading. According to Dan Martin of Milford, a former Trumbull resident, Morton preceded him by several years in elementary school, Tashua School on Stonehouse Road, and then Madison Middle School on Madison Avenue, both in Trumbull. One of Martin's teachers at Tashua told Martin of the wonderful impression Morton made on her while he was her student. As a schoolboy, Morton got an early start in organized baseball when, at the age of 14, he pitched in an AAU tournament in Kissimmee, Florida. Joel Barlow High School. After the family moved to Reading, Morton was enrolled at Joel Barlow High School, where he played baseball all 4 years. He was originally on the junior varsity when coach Jeff Brown approached him in the school cafeteria. The coach told him, "You're going to play with us today," Morton recalled. "It was like I got called up," he said. Morton pitched the rest of his 4 years on the varsity, where the Falcons competed in the Old Southwest Conference. In his final year, he had a 1.18 ERA and 78 strikeouts, and the team reached the SIAC Class M tournament. His fastball was timed then at 92 to 93 miles per hour, and scouts projected that in a few years it would reach the mid-90s. Throughout his senior year at Joel Barlow, he averaged 2 strikeouts, but 1 walk per inning. "I'm pretty sure the first home run I ever gave up in my life, I gave up to a guy from Massac, my freshman year," he said. "At Massac, it's like 400 feet to left field, at least in my mind it is, and it was a bomb. I remember when we played Massac, I felt like we were playing the Yankees." In his senior year, from 20 to 30 scouts came each game to see him throw, measuring the speed of his pitches with radar guns. Baseball was certainly his goal by then. He even put a batting cage and mound in his basement to practice in bad weather. The assistant coach at the time was Mike Santangeli, who is now the athletic director at the school. Santangeli told Julia Perkins of the Connecticut Post recently, October 22, 2017, "Morton was an exceptional player. He was just a really easygoing, great teammate. Just a really kind, polite, nice young man who could throw 92 miles per hour. With all his gifts, with all his ability, he was always just one of the guys on the team. He never walked around with any kind of aura as far as wanting attention. He just wanted to pitch, be part of the team,